Hello students, welcome to our next video. In this video I am going to explain the topic of previously discussed, that is the site selection of our nuclear power plant. Okay, so in the previous video I have explained the 2-3 points. That is, the first one is the availability of water. Okay, so I have discussed all the points related to the availability of water. Then we have transportation, right? Transportation. Okay, how actually the fuel and all the other imported equipments are being transported? Okay, distance from localities, distance. Okay, distance from the localities. Then we have load center. Okay, how the load center should be located near the according to the plant location. Then we have the fifth one is the land quality. It is also an important point, because if I am planning to plant my nuclear plant on such location where the land quality is not good, then why should I plant my plant there? Then I'll do a chemical research on the quality of the land, the soil, okay, and then I'll build my foundation there. So what I'll do, I'll just buy that plant and do a I'll check the quality of the soil. Okay, quality of the soil. If it is able to handle the large load, okay, then this point is also an important land quality. Then site. Then we have the next point, that is site to be avoided. Means it is a nuclear base, right? So it should be avoided from such location, from such localities, so that it does not affect them. Okay, so site to be avoided. Then we have accessibility. Okay, so accessibility to several facilities for the plant should be available at near location. Then availability of space. Availability of space for waste disposal. Okay, so in the nuclear power plant, waste disposal is a major problem. But because we cannot throw that waste directly into the environment or near to our locality, because it has a radioactive element. It can affect the health of the animals or people living nearby. So it should be properly disposed. Okay, it should be properly disposed to such a location that so that it does not come in contact with the persons nearby or the animals nearby. So we need a special space for that purpose. Okay, so these are the site selection criteria. Now I'll explain the block diagram. Okay, I'll explain the block diagram of nuclear power plant. Okay, nuclear power plant. So before proceeding, there are major components. Major components of our nuclear power plant. Okay, major components. So what are the major components? The first one is the atomic reactor. Atomic atomic reactor is there. Okay, so this atomic reactor is also an important one. Then we have heat exchanger. Okay, so heat exchanger is also there to exchange the heat between the two. Two means suppose I want to exchange my heat into the water so that the water should be heated. Then we have filter. Okay, so filter is also an important element. Then we have steam valve. Steam valve. Steam valve is there so that valve is controlled. Valve controls the flow of steam. Then we have turbine. So that heated steam should be imparted on the turbine. Then we have condenser. Okay, that heated steam should be converted back into the water, and then it is again transferred to the condenser where the heat is extracted, and that steam, the water is then again fed to the boiler for boiling with the heat produced through the nuclear. Okay, then we have alternator. Okay, the alternator job is to produce the electricity as in the previous all the power plants we have seen. Then we have exciter. To give the starting torque to the alternator to start this alternator, we need a separate push so that it starts rotating. So exciter is there. Then we have feed pumps. Okay, feed pump is there. So these kind of pumps are used for pumping the water from one location to other locations. So these are the 9 major components used by the nuclear power plant. Okay, atomic reactor. Then we have heat exchanger, filter, steam valve. Okay, steam valve, turbine, condenser, alternator, exciter, and feed pump. Okay, now all these major components, I'll be representing this all the components in a block diagram. So I'll draw the block diagram. Okay. So the first one is the atomic reactor block diagram. Okay. Atomic reactor. This is the atomic reactor. Okay, here our main thing happens. Okay, atomic reactor. Then we have heat exchanger. So heat exchanger is nothing but a, there is a tube, water tube here. Okay, water tube will be here. Means here only the water is circulated, and through that water circulation, the steam is generated, and that steam is then taken out. From this steam is taken out from here. Okay. Okay. Then we have separate filter arrangement here. Filter arrangement. And then we have pump here. Okay, pump. Feed pump is there. Okay. In atomic reactor, here actually the heat is produced and heat is then transferred through here, and then in the heat exchanger the water heated and the steam is generated. That steam is then passed to the feed pump. Okay, feed pump. Okay, or we can directly connect a steam valve. Steam valve. Okay, steam is there. So the valve is nothing but some kind of tap, so that tap actually controls the flow of the steam. Then we have a turbine here. Turbine. So it is called a steam turbine. Okay, then through that steam turbine, the steam is taken out, and then it is passed to the condenser. condenser is there, okay, condenser. Okay, that condenser then pumps the water and pumps the water through the feed pump. Okay, it is then transferred to the exchanger. So again, circulate the water and again generate the steam. Okay, also from the steam condenser we can condense the water and store that into a separate water reservoir. Okay, you can store also. And from also from this also you can, if I use some water pump here, then through that water pump also I can transfer that water into this feed pump. This feed pump, that feed pump I can send the water into the heat exchanger. Okay, this is the heat exchanger. Okay, heat exchanger. Means the water is circulated here only. Water is circulated here only, and that steam turbine rotates the. This is the coupling. Okay, means coupling means this rod is coupled with the generator rod. Okay, so this is the generator. Connected to the exciter, small exciter is there. Means what these exciters do? It actually excites the winding, okay, rotor winding, and it starts, gives the starting torque, and this starting torque, what will happen due to the continuous rotation, it will start generating the electricity in three phases, and that three phases is then transferred to a step of transformer to fund transmission. Okay. For transformer, that three phase again converted means fed to the further network. So this is the block diagram of our nuclear power plant. Okay, so this process is similar to the previous only we have to study the atomic reactor part. But this is how the electricity is generated in the nuclear power plant. Okay. Through the here heat is generated, that heat is passed into the heat exchanger, where water is circulated, that circulated water generates the steam, that steam is then taken out to the turbine. But to control that steam flow, valve is connected, and here the turbine starts rotating, and that steam, the extra steam, is then taken out into the condenser. The condenser condenses the water and store it into the water pump. Also, that steam is medium temperature steam is then passed with the help of feed pump into the heat exchanger again. Means if the water is circulated and steam is circulated here only, that rotating turbine starts rotating, and it again connected to the rotor of that alternator, which rotates the turbine. The rotor of the alternator, and at the end it generates the electricity at its terminal, and we are excited to give the starting torque. So this is the working of our nuclear power plant. Okay, this is the working of our nuclear power plant. Okay, now means there are actually the main component like heat exchanger. Okay, heat exchanger is there. Atomic reactor, steam valve, condenser, feed pumps. Okay, feed pumps is there, turbines is there. This is the coupling. Coupling means this rod is common. It is coupled. Okay, it is coupling this turbine and alternator. Then we have electrical components here. Alternator, exciter, then transformer, then bus bar, etc. Transmission tower and etc. Okay. So this is the block diagram of the nuclear power plant. Now in the previous video I have explained the two topics, that is nuclear fission and nuclear fusion. So these two topics are also important from exam point of view. As I have said, nuclear fission, what is nuclear fission? Nuclear fission means one odd atom is little made up of heavy or largely small element. These are the elements. Let's suppose I am imparting, means I am firing or bombarding charge atom on this element, then what will happen? It will split into small elements. these are split into two elements, but it releases some energy. See, it releases some energy. Okay, this, again then this element is broken down into then it also releases. So the total heat generated will be happened here in atomic reactor. That heat is also we only need. Okay. So for that various fuels are connected. So this is an element means we are using some fuel. So I'll there are actually widely used three fuels. Okay. So this widely used three fuels. So the most widely used one is the uranium. Okay, uranium. Okay, so uranium is actually in three form. Okay, uranium is actually in the three form. Uranium. So it is in the three form: natural uranium, natural the core uranium, okay, then we have a uranium oxide. Okay, uranium oxide. Okay, oxide of uranium, then we have carbide, uranium carbide. Means what is that? The uranium is it is not, means it can be used in the natural form, oxide form or carbide form. Okay, uranium, it has three isotopes. Okay, isotopes. So it has separate formula. 92 uranium is 92U235. Okay, 92U235 is the atomic number. Then UO2. Okay. So uranium, this has the same formula, but O2 is there, means O2 represents the oxide of it. Okay, oxide of it. Then we have second one is the thorium. Okay, then we have the thorium. Okay, so this also has a number of 232 pH 92. It has a atomic number of this. Okay, so these are the fuels which are used by the nuclear in the nuclear reactor. Okay, these are the fuels which are used: natural uranium oxide, carbide, and thorium. And there are also more isotopes which are preferred for generation purpose, but we use this widely. Okay, so this is the some basics of our block diagram. Working and which are the types of fuel which are used by the nuclear power plant. Okay, so in the next video we will see the advantages and disadvantages and some of the important parameters in nuclear reactor or nuclear rod, and some other control rods are there. So we will look at these topics in our next video. Okay, so I hope you understand this video. If you have any kind of doubt, you can contact me. So thank you for watching.